Hello, internet users. My name is JamJ, and it is currently almost 2 o'clock a.m. in the morning. I'm sitting here sucking on a peppermint because I have a tummy bug.
All units, my tummy hurts. I'm gonna need a warm blankie and a cup of hot chalky.
And on my handy-dandy Marvel Unlimited app, I just read the newest Amazing Spider-Man that just dropped, Amazing Spider-Man number 34. And I mean, you saw the title and the thumbnail of the video. Like, I don't think I have to explain how I felt about it. It was just kind of like a straight face the entire time. I didn't really feel much of anything. If you're not caught up with the current Amazing Spider-Man, basically, some dude named Rabin shoved Peter and MJ into this weird, like, dark alternate reality dimension thing, where they meet the writer Zeb Wells self-insert Paul, and Peter gets shoved back into the main world because contrived plot stuff, and time passes differently in Earth 616 compared to this dark dimension, so Peter, you know, burns a whole bunch of bridges trying to get back, but by the time he gets back to that dimension, MJ's with the self-insert Paul. And they adopted some kids, and MJ's like, nah, Pete, I'm not going to get back with you because I find the self-insert so appealing. You know, they were only in there for like 4 years. Like, I mean, maybe if it was 10 years, I would understand, but like, I don't know, but that's besides the point. I should also mention I'm doing this completely unscripted just because why not? So we're just having a little chat here. We're just having a chat. So I get to the end of the book, and I came across this letter. I'm sure some other YouTubers have talked about it, but let's see. We're going to read it, and then we're going to read the response from Marvel Editorial, and then we're going to dissect that response. We're going to dissect it, because the response, I don't know, bugged me more than the story itself. So let's see here. Okay, the letter reads, "Greetings from Mexico. My name is Ricardo Lopez Gonzalez, and I want to express my deepest concern for the current status of the Amazing Spider-Man comics these last few days. Mostly, I would start by saying that as a quote-unquote new reader, I'm deeply saddened by the state of the characters in the current run, particularly Peter's, Mary Jane's, and Ben Reilly's. I wasn't sure about writing this letter because often being from another country makes people not take account of my opinions, but I decided to try, even if I don't get an answer or it isn't even read at all. In particular, Mary Jane is the one who I'm mostly worried about. I'm afraid to ask, but is she really in a romantic relationship with Paul? If she is, I think it's a great disservice to the character, because not only has she been loyal to Peter, she wouldn't start a relationship with someone else while still being in one with Peter, not even with the whole other world circumstances. As a fan of Spidey since I was a kid, I have to ask, please think about the reception this comic has gotten. I know undoing one more day is a usual request, yet I'm still going to politely request it, not only as a fan of Peter slash MJ, but as a fan of Spider-Man comics themselves. I'll also comment on the way that Way Up was portrayed felt a little offensive. As a Mexican, seeing a villain based on my culture excited me, but when actually reading it, it felt not only generic, but also as a lost opportunity. I'm not sure if anyone will read this, but if someone does, please take my opinion and the other dissatisfied fans as something that does matter, especially when it is hard for me to support comic books because of my current economic situation. Thanks for reading. Have a good day. Ricardo Lopez Gonzalez." Now, that was a pretty heartfelt letter. Basically, you know, he wasn't sure he was going to be, you know, listened to. I wouldn't say it's because of his race, but more so because Marvel Editorial doesn't like listening to people that aren't, you know, bootlicking them, essentially. Let's see here. Oh, I'll start with this. Yeah, he's got a point. Peter, Mary Jane, and Ben Reilly are treated very weirdly in this run. That's true. He talks about, you know, is it too late to undo one more day? And one more day is essentially when Peter and Mary Jane sold their marriage and unborn child to Mephisto to bring back Aunt May. And as a way to kind of like soft reboot Spider-Man. It was really dumb. It was very out of character. And it was clearly just forced because
Marvel wanted to keep the character young and relatable and wanted to undo the marriage. There's plenty of videos on that, but, you know, that's pretty common. Wyep, I think Wyep was the guy who sent them to the Dark Dimension, actually, and Rabin was the evil... No, Rabin was Wyep, I think. I read this series and I can't even remember. That's how kind of annoying... Not annoying, but just generic the villain is. No, annoying. I don't know. What even is Wyep? Backwards is P-Yaw. At first when I read Wyep, I thought that was like a name backwards or something. But no, I think that's the name they went with. Oh, and also the self-insert Paul is Rabin, the villain, the big villain of that little story arc. That's his son. Paul is the son. And, yeah, so... Okay. Let's see. I think that's about as much context as I can give regarding that letter. So, you know, obviously, you know, pretty heartfelt letter. You know, he brought up some good points. You know, most fans reading the comic now would say the same thing, probably. If you go to the Spider-Man subreddit, it's not hard to find people that share the same opinion. But let's read what the Marvel editorial office had to say in response. All right. Had to get my obligatory throat clears in. Okay. Thanks for writing in, Ricardo. Sorry you're in a tough economic situation. So many are right now, and we emphasize with you and always try to make these comics worth the hard-earned money you spend on them. And we read the letters you all send in. Sorry you're not liking the book right now. Mary Jane is, as you saw in this issue, still in a romantic relationship with Paul. I honestly don't see what Mary Jane did is unloyal, but your opinion of it is yours. Life puts people through all kinds of situations, and a heightened life like the one Mary Jane lives puts her through even more intense situations. It's not exactly the same, but her story has elements in common with one of my favorite books of all time, Dr. Zhivago by Boris Pasternak. If you haven't read it, I highly recommend it. Anyway, it exemplifies how this world can often take whatever plan you have or story you think you might live and turn those plans upside down. Anyway, you talk about undoing One More Day as a usual request, and also talk about dissatisfied fans. Other people sometimes generalize it as all Spidey fans. You aren't doing this here, Ricardo, but it's something I see quite regularly. There certainly are fans who feel that way, and I respect it, though I don't agree with the thinking. But it is not nearly as monolithic as some believe or assume. Anyway, thanks for reading, Ricardo. Okay. I didn't have much to say about Ricardo's letter, just clarifying, like, One More Day is for new Spider-Man fans tuning in or whatever. But I'm assuming most of you are... This is what you're here for digging into the Marvel editorial. Okay, so... It starts off good. You know, he's like, thanks for writing in. You know, sorry you're in a tough economic situation. But right away, he's like, we try to make these comics worth the hard-earned money you spend on them. But something I would spend my hard-earned money on, a superhero comic, I would spend my hard-earned money on would, you know, even if he's in a tough situation, it would at least make him look, you know, good. You know, make him grow past it. But Peter's just doing nothing this entire, like, book. He works with Norman Osborn. He has a goblin spider suit. He was dating Black Cat, but now he's not. So he's doing nothing. There's nothing being done here. So, and there's just this annoying focus on Mary Jane and Paul. Like, it's holding him back. So, we'll harp on that again in a second. So, he says, he doesn't see what Mary Jane did as unloyal. From Mary Jane's perspective, it probably isn't disloyal, but from Peter's perspective, he was only in the real world for, like, like a day or two when he came back and then this happened. To him, that is extremely disloyal. Like, anytime Peter's perspective is considered in this book, it paints him as holding this petty grudge when, in reality, you know... Obviously, he's going to be hurt. Like, at this point, he feels like he's been cheated on. Like, who wouldn't?
And recently on Marvel Unlimited, they have these, like, Spider-Man Unlimited comics. They're like little infinity comics. They're vertically scrolling. And there's this one right now about the Renew Your Vows Spider-Man continuity. But it starts with 616 Peter swinging around wintertime, thinking about how he wants to be a parent, you know, how sad he is he isn't married. It has no relevance to the story. It's just there to show Peter sad, which is in direct conflict with this book at the end of it. You know, at the end of this Goblin arc where Peter tells Mary Jane, oh, you did nothing wrong. You never did anything wrong. It's all my fault. It's like, no, the dude is still hurting. Okay. Contradiction. And let's see. It says, the letter says, life puts people through all kinds of situations. Mary Jane has this going on. I guess he's trying to say here, you know, at first I'd be like, it's not that deep. It's just Marvel, you know, being Marvel. They don't want 616 Peter to be married because they want to keep him young or whatever. But now, according to this letter, they're trying to tell a story with this. Like, they're trying to have a little hidden message or lesson in this whole Mary Jane Paul thing. And I'm not seeing it. And I guess if this is the message you're trying to tell, it's not a very good one. As a Spider-Man fan, it's not, like, anyone reading as a Spider-Man fan, this is not a good message to send, because Spider-Man has always been the relatable superhero, you know, because of the hardships he goes through, yes. So, but he has to rise above them. You know, this whole thing with MJ and Paul, and he's not rising above it. You know, you could have used Black Cat, you know, they could have had something going, you know, they could have developed an actual relationship, especially with the Ultimate Spider-Man being rebooted, and that one is married to Mary Jane and has kids. You could have done something interesting with Felicia, but no. And I'm willing to bet that Mary Jane and Paul are still going to be in the comics from now on, even after Peter has told Mary Jane, oh, you know, it's not your fault, you know, I forgive you, blah-de-blah. They're still going to be here just to make Peter suffer, just because, I don't know. I really don't know. Maybe it has something to do with the fact that Paul is a self-insert of Zeb Wells. It's pretty obvious. Even his Twitter profile picture, I don't know if it's exactly Paul, but it looks like Paul. And that's kind of astounding to me, because if I was the writer of Amazing Spider-Man, I would be putting Spider-Man as my profile picture. I'd be owning that. Not Paul. I'm all over the place here. He goes on to recommend this book called Dr. Zhivago, which I'm sure is a way better, telling a way better version of what they're trying to tell here with Mary Jane and Paul. And I was telling my friend, I had a point, I was telling my friend, yeah, life can change drastically out of nowhere. But the thing is, the one thing that should stay constant, like, should ideally stay constant, is the people you love and the people who love you. And stories like the MJ, Paul, and Peter one, like that, people reading it, it like subconsciously plants seeds of doubt in people's minds that happiness is temporary and bad things are just gonna happen to you, like, constantly. Even if you are a good person, against your will, and basically you're just gonna have to deal with it, or else you'll be seen as the bad guy or the petty person who holds a grudge. And, I mean, Marvel, is that really the message you're trying to send, like, that you want to send to people looking up to Spider-Man? Like, is this the relatable superhero you want people to give their money to and look up to? And yes, from what I understand, the book has sold fairly well, you know, mainly because they did that, like, thing at the start where, oh, Peter's in trouble, how did we get to this point? And then they just kind of, like, farted around for a while before they eventually revealed it. And there are interesting ideas at play here, especially with, like, Peter getting the goblin serum or goblin curse or whatever. But not much is done with it. You know, it gets resolved pretty quickly. You know, the stuff with Tombstone was kind of fun. The thing with Vulture was stupid, where he beats Peter and Peter screams to Norman to give him the suit. Give him the new goblin suit, even though Peter's beaten this geriatric fart, like, what, 10 million times? I digress. Let's keep on with the letter. Yeah, it... And he says that he doesn't feel like all Spider-Man fans are dissatisfied with One More Day. The majority are. It is as monolithic as it appears to be, because, you know, you ask people and it's like, I don't think there's many people that are like, oh yeah, you know, I just love the state that Spider-Man's in currently due to the effects of One More Day. You know, it's like, there's been highs and lows. Like, me personally, I like Superior Spider-Man, and I liked Parker Industries. And I want to talk about that for a second, because that did the whole life getting in the way thing much better, and I'll explain why. So, this whole thing with Peter, Paul, and Mary Jane is stupid. It doesn't feel deserved. Peter did nothing wrong to deserve this. Like, this doesn't feel like the consequence of anything Peter Parker did. It's just something that happens, and, oh, Peter, get over it, you know, be a grown-up. Like, this dude has every reason to become a supervillain at this point. And he did, for a couple of issues, and then they fixed it. But, so, during the Superior Spider-Man, you know, him and Mary Jane were getting things back on track. But then Otto comes along and takes over Peter's mind. Like, this is kind of like a soft consequence of just Peter being Spider-Man fighting Otto all these years. Well, not a soft consequence, but kind of like an indirect consequence. You know, there's nothing Peter can do about this. And for the most part, you know, he sees Otto try to get with Mary Jane at first and sink it. But then for a while, Peter is out of the picture. So it's like, you know, Mary Jane gets with this firefighter, Owen. This works fine because it's a consequence, you know, of Peter, you know, being the Superior Spider-Man now. But he doesn't have to sit there and absorb all of this. Like, Otto erases him from his mind for a time. So Peter doesn't have to sit there and deal with the emotional gut punch of seeing the woman he loves, you know, with someone else. Especially because after Otto completely sinks it with Mary Jane, like, in Peter's body, he just has nothing to do with Mary Jane hardly. And there's not much of a focus on Mary Jane and Owen. They're just kind of there sometimes, but it's not as much as MJ and Paul and their kids or whatever. So it works. And Peter comes out of the Superior Spider-Man arc with his own company. Did he technically earn this himself? No, but should he have by this point? Yes. And so, you know, he does good with it until he has to resort back to the status quo, you know, because of the clone conspiracy event. You know, that was a decent way to do it. That was a good way to keep Mary Jane and Peter apart. This right here, this isn't doing it. This is just... Oh. It's to the point where rambling about it, I feel like I'm going insane. Just sitting here rambling about it on a whim. We're nearing like 18 minutes of runtime right now. This isn't as long as I wanted to talk about this, but I had a lot to talk about. Again, at the end of the day, like, I'm sure if Marvel Editorial were watching this, they'd be like, it's not that deep. And it's like, on one hand, I agree, because at the end of the day, this is about a funny broke man who climbs walls in red and blue pajamas and shoots white gunk out of his wrists. But according to this letter, they want there to be some kind of deep, impactful thing you take away from this whole storyline. And it's just, nobody's taking that away. All they're seeing is Peter getting kicked in the nuts repeatedly. Their favorite superhero getting kicked in the nuts repeatedly. And, like, not coming out of it. Like, he's constantly getting his crap rocked, mollywopped, by people like the Vulture. You know, Mary Jane doesn't even consider his side of the story. Paul's just there to be the biggest, fattest obstacle ever in comic history. Well, not really. Not really. Paul isn't even anything. Like, you can't even get mad at Paul, because Paul is not fleshed out in the slightest. Like, he's just there. Like, at this point, now that I've crapped on the story, you know, I'm gonna offer a solution. The biggest solution I had was to develop Peter and Felicia. But they shot themselves in the foot. Why did they do that? Why? I don't really know. I think it was kind of stupid. Like, I don't know why they did that. You know, because Ultimate Peter is coming back, and he's going to have Mary Jane, and he's going to have kids. That's going to be great. Everybody loves that. I love Ultimate Spider-Man. I'm satisfied with that. Great. Fantastic. Would I love it to be the 616 Peter? Sure, but, I mean, I guess he had that time already. He didn't have a kid, but, oh, freaking well. It is what it is. They're not going to get Mary Jane and Peter back together anytime soon. Like, that's just the way it's going to be in the 616 continuity. So, honestly, I don't know what to do. Like, if I was in their shoes, I don't know what I would do. I would say come up with some new love interest, but judging by how they're, you know, treating Paul, like, how much of a nothing burger his character is, I really don't trust them to come up with another, like, love interest to, like, rival Mary Jane to be good for Peter. Because it's like, I feel like the closest that's ever gotten to that point was Kitty Pryde in the Ultimate Spider-Man universe. Like, that's the closest it's ever got to rivaling, like, the Mary Jane relationship. Or even Black Cat, but, like, they don't want to do anything with that either, apparently. They just wanted Peter to have a rebound just because, just so they could kind of kick him in the nuts more, because the reason they broke up was because Peter hadn't been telling Felicia to stop doing bad things, stop stealing stuff. So she was like, oh, your heart's not in this, you're just using me as a rebound. And then Peter's like, yeah, I am. Like, bro, how do you fumble Black Cat? I don't even know what to do at this point, because I started reading Brand New Day, and they introduced Carly Cooper as kind of like the new love interest after Mary Jane, and she's such a pick-me girl right off the get-go. It's like, I feel like if they made another self-insert, they would be running into, like, the same sort of problems. It's just like, she has this one, like, she's not a good character, and it makes people want Mary Jane back, and then Mary Jane comes back, and then they split them up again. It's a vicious cycle. So it's like, I feel like the solution was Black Cat, but it's like, now they kind of shot themselves in the foot, unless Peter and Black Cat are just like, oh yeah, that was kind of goofy of us to just split up like that. Let's try it again for real this time. I don't freaking know. This has gone on way too long. This was very rambly. I don't know how many more videos I'm going to make like this of just me talking about Spider-Man comics, but I don't know. I don't know. We'll see. But point being, Zeb Wells' Spider-Man run needs to change. This modern Spider-Man run isn't cutting it. The biggest takeaway from this, if Marvel Editorial was even watching, they probably are not, but if I was Marvel Editorial and I was watching this, the biggest takeaway I would get is make Peter's life improve it, at the very least. Like, maybe have him take a backseat from the relationships for a while until, like, I could figure out something satisfying in the relationship department, because we want to see our boy Peter happy, you know? He may be a fictional character, haha, funny, you know, but it's Spider-Man, okay? Like, it's a form of entertainment. It's a form of escapism. We've seen him go through all the heartbreak imaginable. Let the boy be happy, at least in the 616 continuity. You know, he deserves that much, at least. Or the story deserves that much. Like, Peter isn't a real person. That's what I mean. Like, the story would just, you know what I mean? It would greatly benefit. It would be so much better if, kind of like the Parker Industries run, you just let him grow. Let him grow. They're kind of getting back to that point. You know, he's reconnected with the Fantastic Four and his old roommate. So, you know, there's that aspect at least, but there's so much more that could just be done if they want to take a new, interesting approach with him. Just, I don't know what to say. Except, get rid of Mary Jane and Paul. Yes, Mary Jane is a popular Spider-Man character, but at this point, she's serving no purpose other than to hold Peter back. Same with Paul. So, they just need to go. Anyways, if you made it this far, thanks for listening to me rambling. If you made it this far, compliment
coconut butt cheeks. I don't know why that's the first thing that came to my mind. Maybe it's just because of the fact that if you put two coconuts together, they look like a pair of butt cheeks. But comment that if you got this far. Go ahead. We made it to a fairly even multiplicative of 5 runtime. 25. We made it to that runtime. I need to go to bed. Goodbye. Good lord. This comic run, it needs to change. Now, bye-bye now. Bye-bye. Bye-bye!